The T interval. For example, a dean at a local university wanted to determine the average starting salary for recent graduates receiving an MBA from their School of Business. He randomly sampled 20 graduates and recorded their starting salaries. From the sample of 20 graduates, the mean was $95,093 and the standard deviation was $1,724. Assuming the distribution is normally distributed, construct a 99% confidence interval for the true population mean starting salary for all graduates receiving an MBA from the School of Business. To construct a confidence interval for the population mean, with the sample size being less than 30 and the population standard deviation unknown, we're going to use the following formula. So first we have our point estimate of x bar plus or minus the error. And this time, since the sample size is less than 30, it's going to follow a T distribution rather than a Z distribution. So we have T sub alpha over 2 times S divided by the square root of N. And with the T distribution, we have degrees of freedom, which is equal to N minus 1. So now that we have our formula, let's go ahead and plug in the values. So the sample mean was equal to 95,093. Plus or minus T sub alpha over 2, which is determined based on the level of confidence in the degrees of freedom. So we're trying to be 99% confident, and we have a sample size of 20, and that will help us determine the degrees of freedom. So 20 minus 1 is equal to 19. So with 19 degrees of freedom and 99% confidence, we're going to use the T table to find the critical value. So this very first row tells us the level of confidence, and the very first column tells us the degrees of freedom. Again, for this example, we're trying to be 99% confident, and we have 19 degrees of freedom. So we're going to locate the T critical value that corresponds to this intersection. So with 19 degrees of freedom and trying to be 99% confident, our critical value is 2.86093. So we're going to plug this value into our formula. Our standard deviation was 1724, and the sample size was 20. So again, with these next steps, I'm just going to simplify these into pieces. So the very first thing I'm going to do is take the square root of 20. And the square root of 20 is equal to 4.4721. Next, I'm going to divide and take 1724 divided by 4.4721. And once I take 1724 divided by 4.4721, I obtain 385.501. Next, I'm going to multiply 2.86093 times 385.501. And I obtain 1,102.89. In order to get the lower bound of my confidence interval, I'm going to take 95,093 minus 1,102.89. And I get 93,990.11. And in order to get the upper bound, I'm going to take 95,093 plus 1,102.89. And I get 96,195.89. And so this tells us that we are 99% confident that the true population mean starting salary for all graduates receiving an MBA from the School of Business is between $93,990.11 and $96,195.89.